Hey guys, welcome to Python Learning. In this video, we're going to be talking about few of the simplest tricks in Python programming. Many of you might be familiar with these techniques and already be using these techniques in day-to-day programming. But if you don't know these tricks, then let me tell you, these are small tricks that can change the way you write Python code. And this is the first video in the series. So after watching this video, let us know in comment section if we should create more such videos. So let's start off with number 7. At number 7, we have list comprehension. Without list comprehension, to copy elements from one list to other list, you would be writing the code this way, right? You would be using for loop, and inside that for loop, you would be writing the condition when you want to append the value from the other list into this list. So let's run this. This code works fine, but we can write the same in much better way. Let's see how. If we are using list comprehension, we would simply be writing element for element in second list. We want to copy the elements from second list if the element is an even element. So list mod 2 is 0. So these will be the elements in first list. That's it. Let's save this and let's run this. So see, we get the same result, 6, 8, 12, and 10. Number 6 is dictionary comprehension. Let's say you're given a list and you want to create a dictionary out of this list, such that keys are the elements present in this list and the corresponding values are 1 plus the respective element. So this way, using dictionary comprehension, you can do that. So let's print this D. Let's run this. So this is the dictionary that we are getting, that we have created from the given list. Let's take another example. Let's say this is D1, and now we're gonna create another dictionary, this time from enumerate. So we're gonna say for keys we have I, and for corresponding value we have j. For ij in enumerate that we have created by passing range function till 10. So this is how we can create dictionary from enumerate, and now let's print this dictionary D2 and let's run this. So see, we get dictionary that we have generated from enumerate. Now another example, this time we're going to generate dictionary from keys function. So we're going to say dict dot from keys, and from keys function takes iterable and value, iterable to generate the keys and value, which is default to all the keys. So here as iterable, we are taking range function, and as default, we are passing none. Let's print this dictionary D3 and let's run this. So see, this is the dictionary that we just created. Number 5 is zip function. Zip function in Python takes iterables, it zips them to result to a new iterable. For example, if we zip A and B, we can collect the result in a list. Let's print this list and see what we get. So let's run this. So see, it results to a series of tuples containing elements from each iterable. Now if one iterable is having elements more than the other, let's say this iterable is having learning, and if we run this, then the extra element gets ignored. We can also collect this in any other container, for example in set, for example in a dictionary. Let's run this. So in case of dictionary, you get keys from first iterable and values from another iterable. Number 4 is swap. To swap the values in Python, we don't need to do much. We just need to reverse the order while replacing the values. So let's print A and B. And we will see that now A is having object and B is having two. On number three, we have lambda functions. In Python, to write a single statement function, you can use lambda. Writing lambda is very easy. You just say lambda and then you write the input parameters to your function, and now comes the single statement or expression. So this way we have created this function mul, in which we are going to pass the values of A and B to invoke it. Let's run this and it gives correct result. So this way you will be writing more concise code. On number two, we have reversing a list. Say you're given a list, and to reverse this list, you will say a.reverse, and now you will try to print the result returned by a.reverse, right? So when you run this, you find out that it does not return anything. So it's a common misconception that a.reverse or reverse function is going to return anything, whereas it does not return anything, but the list gets reversed. So if you want to get the result, you need to use the A itself. And now on number one, we have sorted versus sort. Let's say again we are having a list, and now to sort this list, we're going to use sort function. So this is going to return a new list B, and we are going to print this new list. So you got it right, it is not going to return anything, just like reverse. If you want to have something that return another list, then we gotta use sorted function. So the sorted will return a new list having all elements from A in sorted order. But if we are using sort call, then it will not return anything. Instead, it's gonna sort that list itself. So we got to print A here. A. So we get 1, 2, 4, 6.